Good morning to all. I hope you all are fine at your home and keeping yourself healthy. I, Ms. Kunjan Daswani from Shiv Jyoti Educational Group Kota, welcome you all to the revision class of English text, and today we are going to revise chapter 1, that is Invention of Shoes, chapter 2, Ivan's Story, and poem number 1, that is Books by Eleanor Fagin. So first, we are going to revise chapter number 1, The Invention of Shoes. So first, let's look the main characters of this story, that is King Hobu, Gobu Rai and the Chief Tanner. So King Hobu and the Gobu Rai, which was his minister, and the Chief Tanner. So this story is basically about a king. The story is about a king named Hobu, who was actually very worried. He was thinking all night about a problem. Now, second point is telling us about his problem. What was his problem? His problem was that why should my royal feet get dirty whenever I step on the ground? So that was the problem of King Hobu. Third, discussion with his minister. So what he did, he called his minister and told him to solve his problem. Now, who was worried? Now, Gobu Rai was worried that if I didn't solve the king's problem, he will fire me. Okay. Now, fourth, gathering of all the learned men and scholars. So, what Gobu Rai did, he gathered all the persons he could. He gathered all the men, all the scholars, all the scientists, all the mechanics to solve the king's problem. And they all cracked their brains to solve the king problem. And they finally decided that they will be doing the dusting of the kingdom. That is the fifth point. That is the dusting of the kingdom happened. They purchased 17,50,000 brooms for the dusting of the kingdom. Now, what this dusting created in the kingdom? That everybody was coughing and sneezing. So this was a very much foolish idea that they have thought about it, right? Now, what idea was given by the king himself? The king gave the idea to cover the whole earth with the leather. So the king ordered to call all the tanners. Now, who are tanners? People who make leather. Okay, now the king ordered to call all the tanners to make leather for covering the whole earth. Now, the chief tanner was called. Now, the chief tanner of the kingdom was called to solve the king's problem. And now what happened? What idea he gave? So, invention of shoes. How invention of shoes happened? So, chief tanner of the kingdom gave an idea that instead of covering the whole earth with leather, we should cover what? The king's feet with the pair of shoes. So they finally decided. Now what happened? They all were creating a havoc and they all were discussing to fire this, to kill that chief tanner. So in that time, he prepared a fresh pair of shoes for king and presented before him. So he was very happy whenever he wore that pair of shoes. He felt very warm. The feet felt very warm, very much comfortable, and very much clean. So this was the thing that this has happened, and that is how invention of shoes happened. So that is the title of the story. That is invention of shoes. This was the story of chapter 1. Now we are going to discuss the internal questions of this chapter. Please hold a pencil in your hand. Now, question number 1. What was the name of the king? Students, this is given on page number 1, and you can mark this question on the first line, and the answer is also given on the first line itself, that is King Hobu. So what was the name of the king? That was King Hobu. So this story is about which king? That is King Hobu. Now, second question, how many brooms were purchased for the dusting of the kingdom? So this question you can mark on page number 2. So how many brooms they purchased? They purchased 17,50,000 brooms. So this is also being given on page number 2. So you can mark this line in your book on page number 2. So question number 3, how did the king's feet feel after wearing the shoes? So this question is given on page number 4. You can mark this question on page number 4. And the answer to this question is given on page number 4 from the starting 4th line. So answer is warm, snug and clean. So warm, the king's feet felt what? Warm, snug means comfortable and clean after wearing the shoes. So this is the answer for the 3rd question. Now we are going to discuss the copy work of this chapter. So as you have got this copy work as a PDF attached with the video. So question number 1, what was King Hobu's problem? So what was King Hobu's problem? What was he thinking about all night, right? So King Hobu's problem was his feet, which got dirty whenever he stepped on the ground. He wanted that his feet should be dust free. So in this question, we are telling that King Hobu's problem was what? His problem was, whenever I step on the ground, why should my feet get dirty, right? This was his problem, and he only wanted that his feet should be dust free. His feet should be very clean. Now, second question, why was Gobu Rai worried? Now, why was Gobu Rai worried? What was the reason for getting worried? So, he was worried as the king wanted him to find out the solution to his problem, and he didn't know how to solve his problem. So, this why was Gobu Rai worried? As I told you, that king called Gobu Rai and he told him to solve his problem, right? So this was the reason for getting worried, that king wanted him to solve his problem, and he himself was not knowing that how to solve king's problem. So that was the reason. That was the reason why Gobu Rai was worried. Okay. Now question 3. How did Gobu Rai try to solve his problem? Now what Gobu Rai did to solve the king's problem? So Gobu Rai gathered all the scientists, scholars and ministers to find a solution to the royal's problem. So he was also very worried, as we have seen in the story also, right? That he was very much worried that if he didn't solve king's problem, king would kill him or he would fire him, right? So that is why he gathered what? He gathered all the persons he could, as this I have told you in the story also, that he gathered all the scientists, scholars and all the learned men to solve the king's problem. Now question number 4, what was the suggestion that the king gave to his problem? Now on this thing, what was the king's idea? We have seen this in the previous slide also, right? What was the king's idea to solve his problem? Okay, the King Hobu suggested that the whole world should be covered with a leather blanket to protect it from the dust. Okay, now King Hobu suggested that what? That the whole world, like he suggested, now when every idea got... Now when every idea got failed, so king only has to give his own idea. And his idea was to cover the whole world with the leather blanket to protect himself from the dust. Okay. Question 5. Who solved the king's problem and how? Now who was the person who gave the final idea and who has solved the king's problem and how? So the chief planner of the kingdom solved the problem. So as we have seen in the story also, that who solved the king's problem? That was the chief planner of the kingdom. Okay, he solved the king's problem. Instead of covering the whole earth, he covered the king's feet by making a pair of shoes for his feet. So what he did? He prepared a warm, a comfortable and a very clean shoes for king's feet. So this was his idea, to instead of covering the whole earth, we should cover the king's feet with the pair of shoes. So this was question number 5. Now we are going to see reference to context. You were supposed to get rid of dust, not fill the world with it. Now this line was said by whom? A part, who said these words? So King Hobu said these words. So these words were said by King Hobu. B, why did he say so? Now, why has he said so? So, he said so because the dusting of the kingdom with brooms created so much dust that everyone was coughing and sneezing and nobody could see anything clearly. So, this line was said by the king when there was dusting of kingdom. Now, when the kingdom was all filled with dust. So, they were all, because of the dust, no one could see anything clearly. Everyone was coughing and sneezing because of dust in the air, dust particles in the air. So, this was the reason of saying this line for the king. Okay. Now, we are going to revise chapter number 2, Ivan's story. So, this chapter's main characters are Mud, or I can say Ivan. Second is Mac and third is Helen. So, these are the main characters of the story. And this story is about Ivan, or I can say Mud, which was a gorilla. So, we are telling about the life which he has forgotten. The life of his past, his jungle life which he has forgotten. So, now we are going to discuss about the story. The first point is the grunt. So, why this grunt is over there? So, in this point, we have discussed about the mud, that is Ivan. Ivan was born in the dense rainforest of Central Africa. He was born in dense rainforest of Central Africa, and that was the time when he was very small, and he has a twin sister named Tag. So, they used to play with their father and they used to bounce on his belly. So, at that time, the father used to react to this act of them, and he used to shout them with a grunt sound. That is, grunt means a short, low sound. Now, Mud. Now, how Ivan, like how the baby gorilla got his name as Mud. So, these gorillas don't used to name like the human beings do. Like they don't used to name the babies like the human beings do. They used to name their babies by watching their habits, after watching their behavior. That after that they used to name their babies. So that was the reason of getting the baby gorilla named as Mud, because he loved to draw pictures on rocks and on rocks and bricks. So that is why they named him as Mud, because he draw pictures using mud. So his parents named him as Mud. Third is protector. So who was the protector for his family, for Mud's family? The protector for Mud's family was the silverback of that family, the main head of the family, that was his father. He was a guide, he was a teacher, he was a protector for Mud and his family. So, in the fourth point, the perfect life. What was the perfect life for Mud? So, for Mud, perfect life was to live a life freely in the jungle. So, that was the perfect life for Mud, because they used to do everything, they used to walk freely, they used to learn from their mother to what all things they require to be an adult. So they used to learn to ride, to climb on trees, to move from tree to tree, to beat their chest. So these are the things they used to learn when they are becoming an adult from a baby. So that was a perfect life for Mud. The end of the perfect life. So, how this perfect life ended? When the humans came and captured them. So, this was the end of the perfect life for Mud. Now, wine. So, wine is like, in this point, I will say that the Mud and his sister was captured by humans, as I told you in the previous point, and they were kept in a cramped dark crate. So, now they have to forget their old life and they have to accept that new life for themselves. But his sister was not able to live this kind of life, so she died. Now the temporary human. Who was the temporary human for Mud? So temporary humans were Mac and Helen, who raised him, who raised him like a human baby. They used to treat him like a human baby. He used to drink water from a bottle. He used to sleep on a human bed. He used to sit on a human chair. So these are the things Mac and Helen used to treat him like their own baby, like their own baby, a human baby. So now hunger. What was the hunger for? Hunger was for missing his family, missing his old life. So that was the hunger for mud, because he missed his life of jungle and he was very much alone, now, as he now lived in the mall. He was now kept as a showcase, a dummy like we have on when we go to a shop. So now he was living that life which he didn't like even for once. But now he has to accept this, and he used to miss his old life, his jungle life. So this was chapter number 2, that is Iman's story. Now we are going to discuss the internal questions of this chapter. Now, question 1, what does Iman mean by silverback? You can mark this question on page number 13. You can open your books to page number 13 and mark this question on the heading given protector. In that heading, you can see the last line and you can mark this answer: a guide, a teacher, and a protector. So this is the answer for first question. You can mark this. What does Iman mean by silverback? Silverback means what? A guide, a teacher, and a protector, which was whom? Which was his father. Now question number 2, who raised Mud like a human baby? So it's given on page number 14 under the heading the temporary human. You can mark the answer on the second line, that is Mac. Who raised Mud like a human baby? Mac, because Mac was the person who took him out of the crate and raised him like a human baby. Now question 3, what was the name of Mac's wife? Now what was the name of Mac's wife? That was Helen, and this question is also on page number 14 under the heading the temporary human. You can mark this question on page number 14 itself on the same topic, that is the temporary human. Now we are going to discuss the copy work of this chapter. Question number 1, why did the parents name Iman as Mud? So what was the reason of naming the Iman as Mud? The baby gorilla loved to draw pictures on rocks and bugs using mud. Observing this, they named him as Mud. So I told you now that these gorillas don't used to name the way the humans do. They used to observe their habits, their behaviors, and then they used to name them. So the baby gorilla used to love to draw pictures on rocks and bricks and I can say bugs using mud. So he loved doing this, so that's why his parents named him as Mud. Now question number 2, when did the perfect phase of Mud's life ended? So what was the time when there was the end of the perfect life for Mud? When human beings trapped Mud and his sister Tag and carried them in a cramped dark crate, their perfect life ended. So as I told you in the topic, the end of the perfect life, that time I told you, right, when they were captured by humans and they were kept in the cramped dark crate, that time was the end of the perfect life for Mud. Now question number 3, what are the skills young gorillas learn after separating from their mother? So to become an adult from a baby, they learn to make nest out of branches, how to breathe their chest, how to move from tree to tree, and be strong and loyal. So these were the things, these were the skills being learned by young gorillas when they are separating from their mother. Like they used to, for to become an adult from a baby, they have to learn so many things. As I told you in the topic the perfect life, it's given there also in your book, which is on page number 14. You can see, so you can see what all things they used to learn: to make nest, to beat their chest, to be strong, to be kind, and to be loyal. Okay, so these are the things they used to learn to become an adult. Now question number 4, how did Mud's father help Mud and Tag? So how did Mud's father used to help Mud and Tag? Now let's see, Mutt's father, the silver bag, would lead them to the ripest fruits to eat, the finest branches for their nest. He was a true guide, a teacher and a protector. As I told you that who was the silver bag for Mutt? That was his father. He used to help him do lots of things like to reach to the ripest fruits to eat, to the finest branches for their nest. To make their nest, they have to search for the finest branches, and for them he was a true guide, a teacher and a protector. Or I can say he was a silver bag for their family. Now question number 5, how did Mac and Helen take care of Mutt? So they raised him like a human baby. They both used to take him wherever they went, whether it was a restaurant, grocery store, movie theater and even to a circus. They made his life an exciting one. So now in the topic the temporary human, we have studied this, like they raised him like a human baby. Mac and Helen were the person who raised him like their own baby. Wherever they used to go, they used to take him along with them, and wherever they are going, he also is going with them. So according to the thinking of gorillas, like Ivan's parents, or I can say Mutt's parents, like they used to aware them from the behavior of humans, because for them humans were very crucial. So that was the thinking being made in Mutt's mind also. But when he met Mac and Helen, this thing has totally changed, because he has seen the new face, a new change in the behavior of humans, and they made Mac and Helen were the person that made his life an exciting one. So this is question number 5. Now we are going to discuss reference to context. Still sometimes I lay awake wishing for the warmth of another just like me. So this line was said by whom? Who is I? In the above lines, I refers to Mutt. So who is I? This line is being said by Mutt itself. Now question number 2, what does the speaker mean in this line? So what does the speaker, what does Mutt mean to say? Why did he say this? The speaker felt lonely and missed his family and his life of jungle. So why he said this thing? Because he was missing his old life, because he was missing his jungle life. That's why he said this line, and he was feeling very lonely. Now see, was he truly happy in his life with the humans? So was he truly happy with the life of humans that he was living? No, he was not truly happy in his surroundings, although he had adjusted well. He missed the love and warmth of his natural home. So in this question we can see, was he happy? No, he was not happy, though humans were very good to him, like Mac and Helen were very good to him, but other humans were not. Like although he had adjusted well in that surroundings, but he used to miss his old surroundings. He used to miss his natural home, which was his jungle life, which was the life which he lived with his parents, with his sisters, with his brothers. The life he missed that life. So that was the reason that why he was not happy in the life with the humans. Now this was chapter number 2. Now we are going to discuss poem 1, that is book, which is written by Eleanor Fagin. So in the first paragraph, the poet Eleanor Fagin is saying that whenever we used to open a book, we used to go in the wonders of land. Book are the wonderful things when we are opening them. Like when we open them and we used to go in the other world, we used to step up in the other world which we are imagining in our mind. Now in the second paragraph, when we are reading a book in a room all alone, physically we are present in that room, but mentally our mind is somewhere else. We are sitting with the chosen friend. Who is the chosen friend? Chosen friend is the favorite character of the book which we are reading. So we go in that world, like physically we are there, but mentally we are not there, we are not in the room, we are imagining ourselves in the life of the book's story. Okay, so in stanza third, we can say that we are sailing with the words in the book to somewhere unknown, which is something unknown. Now in the last paragraph, this poet is saying that book is like a magic box. Like, why he said this? Because whenever we touch book, we used to go beyond that book. We are very much involved in that book, that we would hardly strive for any other company. We don't need anyone else except that book. So that is why the reason for saying book as a magic box. So this was poem 1. Now we are going to discuss the copy work, that is with the reference to context. The room we sit in melts away, and we find ourselves at play with someone who before the end may become our chosen friend. So this is the text. Now we are going to discuss its question. A. Name the poem and the poet. So the name of the poem is Books, which is written by Elena Fargen. So the name of the poem is Books, and it's written by Elena Fargen. Okay. Now B part. Why does the room melts away? The poet says the room melts away because when a poet reads a book, he or she forgets everything. So as I told you in the second paragraph, when we were discussing the poem, that time also I told you, whenever we are reading a book, so that time when we forget everything, so the room melts away is said because of that only. Now see, who is the chosen friend in the last line? As I told you also, that the chosen friend is the favorite character from the book. Now let's read. A chosen friend is the reader's favorite character with whom he or she could identify and relate. So this might have happened with you too. Like whenever you read a book, like you used to involve that, you have a favorite character in that book and which you relate by to yourself. That's me. Like in this story, that's me. So you used to identify or relate to that favorite character. That is the chosen friend being said over here. So this was the revision for chapter 1, that was the invention of shoes, chapter 2, Ivan's story, and poem 1, books. For the detailed videos, you can watch the previous videos also. And I hope you have understood. Thank you.